understand that she was sitting with that who he was, the Christ.
Uh-huh.
So now we move down and we're talking here, and she starts talking, and they start saying that our fathers worship in this mountain and in Jerusalem, there where the men have worship. And Jesus began to speak unto her and began to say that, you know, there will be a time now,
right,
where the people, where you will not be able to get to the mountain. You will not be able to get to Jerusalem. How many times when you look in and you've been in your life that you were not in a place to get to church?
Yeah.
Come on, I need y'all to talk back to me because I'm moving quickly, because there's mighty men that are going to preach after me. But how many of y'all know that when you was in your hellish situation, when you was at home, the people were backstabbing you and the people was getting on your nerves? How many of y'all know that you couldn't get to the church at that time?
Yeah.
But Jesus began to talk to the woman and tell her that this is the time where ye worship what you don't know. A lot of times we see that people are worshiping things that they don't know. You say, preacher, how are they worshiping things that they don't know? There's people that worship their TV. I ain't hearing nothing.
They don't know it. They don't know the spirit that's behind
it. And these things that we get caught up in. We get caught up in these eternal, we get caught up into these things.
Slow down, sir. Slow down, sir.
Material thing, that's right. We get caught up into these things and we begin to worship them. We begin to sit down with them more than we sit down with our word. We begin to sit down with them more than we sit down in the presence of God. But look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, what are you here for?
Such a question.
So Jesus was sitting down with the woman and he began to say, well, listen, you worship things that you don't know. We worship for the salvation is of the Jews. So he was basically saying that the hour is coming.
Uh-huh.
And then he said, well, you know what? Matter of fact, the hour is here. That where we're going to worship God in spirit and in truth. There's so many times that we come into the body of Christ, where we're in the body of Christ, where we realize that people come into the church and they play in the church.
Uh-huh.
A lot of people, you know, I tell people all the time that I am a worshiper.
Yes.
You know, I love to praise.
Mm-hmm.
I can't dance to save my life, but, you know, I love to praise. I love to see people that go up into a mighty praise. I love to see people dance and shout and praise God for the things that he has done. But this is the hour. This is what the word says.
Watch it!
The hour that we must... that God is seeking for true worshipers.
Uh-huh.
Not people that's fake in the Lord.
Uh-huh.
Not people that are walking around on Monday and they're doing what they want to do on Wednesday, and then Thursday and Friday comes, they're in a club, and then Saturday comes, they're trying to rejuvenate for Sunday morning worship. Y'all ain't saying nothing. God is calling for a true worshiper. He's calling for people that will worship him in spirit and in truth, because the Bible even went down and said, because you know people like to tear up the word and they like to, well, you know, God, the hour is coming when God is seeking true worshipers and the Father in spirit and in truth. How can we worship God in spirit and truth? Some people go against the word.
Yes, they do.
I know them.
They go against the word. They go against the word and they say all types of things and they use the word. But listen what the scripture says, and this is Jesus talking. He said God is a spirit.
Yes.
God is a spirit, and the Bible goes on. As I was reading my word, John gives about three descriptions of God.
Yes.
He gives three. God is a spirit in John chapter 4. Then in John 1 chapter 4 and 8, he says that God is love.
Yeah.
How is it that we can come into church and not talk to our neighbor?
That's right.
But we proclaim that we are Christian. How is it that we walk around with all these titles and we walk around with all these things and we proclaim that God is love in our
life? Yeah, the wrong spirit.
You can't have the spirit of God.
Right.
You can't have the spirit of God and you walking around saying, well, I don't like this person.
There's no
like
way.
That is not a true worshiper.
Yeah. That's not a child.
God is calling in this hour, in this season, God is calling for a true worshiper. Now it says that he is a spirit, he is the love, and God is the light. He is the light.
That's right. Come on.
He is a spiritual being, yep. Someone that we can, someone that we cannot see, but we know that he's here.
Uh-huh.
We can feel his presence. God is calling, again, let me go back to the word so I don't stray too far off, but the hour cometh now is when the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For God, for the Father, seeketh such to worship him.
Yeah.
I said, wow, I was sitting down when I was studying my word. For some reason, I can't write down notes. For some reason, I have no notes on this paper. I have a theme, a topic, and a scripture. So God started downloading some stuff into my mind as I was sitting down, and he was saying, you know what? This is what he's seeking. He is looking for this. Like I said before, everybody can praise. Everybody can dance and shout. David was one of the best praisers in the Bible. He danced out his clothes.
Yeah.
He was a praiser.
Such a praiser.
The word clearly states that he is seeking for a worshiper. Someone that can worship him in spirit and truth. What is this word worship? And I'm about to sit down. I think my time is up.
Yeah.
But what is this thing worship? We, the people of God, have got this misconstrued. We feel that worship is a slow song. Y'all ain't saying nothing.
Come on!
We feel that worship is a tempo. Y'all ain't saying nothing. A tempo. T-E-M-P-O. A tempo.
All right.
We think that worship is a melody. That's what we think.
Come on here, sir.
But let me tell you something. What I've realized in the past 3 years that God has been talking to me, God has been telling me things, you have to live this thing that's a worship.
Yeah, it's a lifestyle.
Worship. Look at your neighbor and say worship.
Worship.
It's a lifestyle.
It's a lifestyle.
I worship him in spirit and truth, and I'm not living it. Oh, we got quiet. Wow, it got quiet.
Yeah.
How can you worship God in spirit and in truth,
yes,
if you're not living it?
Oh my.
Unless we go back to the fruits of the spirit with
my
the
God.
Love, peace, joy. How are we living worship and we don't have these traits in us?
Right.
Y'all ain't saying
ain't
nothing.
That's
good though.
He's
this
coming
is good
through
teaching
here.
Because I know that God gave this to me.
Yeah.
So then I know that this is good teaching. But God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth.
Yes.
So look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, what are you here for?
What are you here for? Yeah.